हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी येट अनदर सर्चिंग एल्गोरिदम दैट इज डेप्थ फर्स्ट सर्च। बिफोर गोइंग इनटू द डिटेल्स ऑफ डेप्थ फर्स्ट सर्च, लेट मी टेक अ रिव्यू ऑन ब्रेड्थ फर्स्ट सर्च एल्गोरिदम व्हिच इज द फर्स्ट अनइनफॉर्म्ड सर्च टेक्निक, ब्रेड्थ फर्स्ट सर्च। ओके, सो वी विल टेक अ रिव्यू ऑन दिस and then we will go to the next algorithm, that is depth first search. In short, it is called as BFS and it is DFS, depth first search. So in this breadth first search, generally the searching goes along a breadth, along the breadth direction, breadth wise. Okay, the algorithm searches the goal state, goal node, breadth wise, that means level by level. And here it goes, it searches, the algorithm in this case searches the goal node along the depth wise, okay, not the breadth wise. So this is the difference. So what exactly breadth first search algorithm is, let us go through the example we took. In this example we find that there was a starting initial node, start node or initial state we can say, and this is a goal state or goal node, okay, or target node, or we can also say it is a destination node. So for a certain problem, for example the search tree is like this for a certain problem. Here in the case of breadth first search, the traversing of graph is in this fashion. The algorithm says that loop each node by traversing level by level until the goal state is not found. So you need to start searching, the algorithm starts searching the goal state, goal node, from root node. So this is the initial node or start node or root node, more technically it is called as root node. From root node it searches on the next level, its successor, it expand, yes node expands to A, then the goal test is performed. If the goal test says that the current node is a goal node, then the search is stopped. Otherwise it goes to the next node in the same level or on along the same breadth. This is the breadth, or you can say level. Okay, it will not go to the next level, the search will not go to the next level from the previous level until and unless all the nodes of the previous level are finished searching. Okay, then the search goes to the B node, and after B node again it goes to C, D, E, C, D, G, H, like so on. Every time whenever the search reaches to the next node, goal test is performed. Goal test will check whether the current node or current state is a goal state or not. If not, then it will go on searching the next nodes in the same level. Okay, so this is the idea behind the breadth first search algorithm. For this particular problem, for this particular search tree, the breadth first search traverses the path towards the goal state K in this manner, from S to A, A to B, B to C, C to D, G, then H, then E, then F, and then I, and after I it goes to K, then the solution is obtained. Here the solution is obtained. Solution is obtained means goal state is reached, goal node is reached. So this is the idea of breadth first search. Here you can find the time complexity of this breadth first search is B to the power D, where B is branching factor. Branching factor, you know, it is a average number of child nodes for a parent in a given search tree, and D is the depth of shallowest solution or shallowest path, that means length of shortest path from, this is very important, from initial state or initial node to the goal state or goal node. This complexity is also same time com this complexity this value is also same in case of space. So space complexity and time complexity are same. Both complexity depends on what is the depth and what is the branching factor for the search tree of the given problem. For different problems, search tree will be different. This search tree is for one type of problem, searching problem. For another searching problem, the search tree will be different. Okay, this also you have to remember. Is it complete? Is it breadth-first search is complete? Yes, it is complete. Which means if the shallowest goal node is not at some finite depth, then breadth-first search will find a solution. It gives optimal solution. Yes, possible, but if the cost of each node is same, cost of attaining the each node is same. If it is so, then and then only the algorithm is optimal. Depth-first search. It is a recursive algorithm, very important, because it backtracks the tree, search tree. It is called DFS because it starts from root node and follows each path to its greatest depth node before moving to the next path. That means once it takes this particular route, for example, if from start node it starts the work, if it takes this particular path, then it will complete this path. If along this path from S to A, A to C, C to E, E to K, if K is the search node, if K is the goal node, then it will stop searching. Otherwise, if K is not a goal node, suppose I is a goal node, then first it covers this particular depth, it completes this path and then backtracks to F. Because the parent node to this K is E, but E is already traversed along this route, that's why it backtracks, the search algorithm backtracks to the next node on along the other path. Again, it will try to go to C, but C is already traversed, therefore it will go to D. Okay, and then from D it will backtrack to, it can go to A or it can go to G, but already A is traversed, therefore it goes to G. After G, then it will go to I. In this way the goal node can be achieved if the goal node is I. Okay, so this is the concept of depth first search. So let me take one example of a particular search tree for any given problem. This is the search tree for a typical search problem. Let us consider this search tree. Here what happens, it starts searching from root node, traverse A, then B, then D, like this. Starts from S, traverse A, then B, then D, and as the goal node is G, therefore this particular path is completed, therefore the search algorithm backtracks the previous node, but as the B is, D can backtrack to B, but B is already traversed, therefore it will backtrack to next node E. Okay, again the goal test is performed, E is not a goal node, therefore the algorithm backtracks to another intermediate node, that is C. Again the goal test is performed, and after the goal test it is found that C is not a goal node, therefore it will backtrack to the next node because A is already covered. It can, from C it can backtrack to A, but as A is already covered or traversed, therefore it backtracks to G, and again the goal test is performed. So therefore if the goal test says that G is the goal node, then the searching will be stopped. So this way the DFS algorithm works, and this is what description here we have mentioned. Okay, generally it will follow this order from root node to the left node, because from this root node there are two paths, A and H, two child nodes are there, two successors are there. So generally the left node will be expanded. Okay, from S, A will be expanded or explored. H is not explored because it is on the right side. So this is the rule for depth first search. So this way depth first search work. Let us go through the theoretical part. The breadth first search works on the first in first order, first out order. But here, depth first search works on LIFO, last in, first out order, which is based on the stack. In order to expand the unexpanded nodes, means unexplored nodes, which are not traversed yet. Unexpanded means unexplored. Unexplored means not traversed, untraversed in the search tree. The search proceeds to the deepest level of the tree where it has no successor. That means here it goes to the deepest node D, but after D there was no successor. Therefore, it will backtrack if the D is not a goal node. This search expands nodes till infinity. That means the depth of the tree. It goes to the, it reaches the depth node, okay, where you find there are no successor to that particular node. So last in, first out means what? Here, the last in, first out. So here is the stack, for example. The node which is entered first is moved out first. Sorry, the node which is last in. So which node is last in here in this case? For example, S is first, then A is first, then B is the next node we traversed, then D is the next node we traversed. But for this particular path, as D is not a goal node and the depth is already achieved, depth node is already traversed, therefore the last element or last node which we entered or we traversed was D. Therefore D is thrown out. So the search space goes to search space now enters into C. So sorry, E. So E will be entered here. So B, A and C will be remain as it is. So this is the concept of last in, first out. So what is the, how the algorithm works? Theoretically it can be stated in this fashion. Set a node, one node as a root node. Set a variable goal which set a goal node. You can mention here step one as set root node, set goal node, like this. Loop each node by traversing deeply in one direction or path in search of the goal node. So you have to traverse deeply in only one direction. In general, that direction is the left direction from the root node. While performing the looping, the start removing the elements from the stack in last in, first out order. If the goal state is found, then return goal state, otherwise backtrack to expand nodes in the other direction. Okay, so this algorithm backtracks the search tree so as to find the goal node. What are the advantages of it? It requires very less memory as it only needs to store a stack of the nodes on the path from root node to the current node. It takes less time to reach to the goal node than BFS, provided that it is traversing in the right path. If it is not traversing in the right path, then it will take more time. What are the disadvantages? It may get trapped in infinite loop. What does it mean? For example, if the search tree is like this and goal node is somewhere here, G is the goal node, and suppose after D there are so many nodes, further nodes, if there are infinite nodes in this particular direction, in this direction, so ultimately what will happen? The search algorithm will traverse from this node to this node, this node to this node, this node to this node, and so on, and it will not complete, it will not reach the depth node in time. So it will take infinite time to reach the shallowest node or depth node or the last node where there is no successor. That means if there are infinite nodes, large number of nodes or infinite nodes in this direction, in this, along this path, so it will never come out, it will not be able to backtrack to so as to get the G. That means it will get trapped in infinite loop. So this is the major disadvantage of DFS. It is also possible that it may not reach the goal state. Just I explained right now, if the left path in the previous diagram has infinite number of nodes, then it will not reach the goal node, that is G, if there are infinite number of nodes along this path. It does not give you the optimal solution. It may give you optimal solution, but it is not. It can give you solution, but it is not optimal solution, low cost solution. This is also disadvantage of DFS. What are the performance parameters, performance measures? Completeness. DFS does not guarantee to reach the goal state. Why? Because of this disadvantages. It will not guarantee to reach the goal state. Okay, it can reach to the goal state. For example, here in this case, it reached the goal state, but it is not always the case. Why? Because this search tree is very small. If the search tree is very large and complex, and along this left path, if there are infinite nodes, then it will not reach the goal state. So that is why we can say that the DFS algorithm does not guarantee to reach the goal state. Not always. Optimality. It does not give optimal solution as it expand nodes in the one direction very very deeply, and if that one direction is very very large, very shallow, then in that case it will take a lot of time to reach to the goal node, if the goal node is not along that deep path. If there is a deep path like this and there are so many infinite nodes along this path, and suppose unfortunately our goal node is not along this path, goal node is somewhere else, then after traversing like this, it will take a large time to complete this particular path, and then it will try to backtrack like this to reach the goal node. So that's why the solution will not be optimal in this case, because it expands, or it explores, the algorithm explores in one direction very very deeply. So it depends. If your search tree is very deep in one direction, and suppose this is the first path of exploration, then optimal solution is not guaranteed. Space complexity. The space complexity formula is same, where B is the branching factor and D is the depth of shallowest solution. Time complexity. Space complexity and time complexity are same. Both depends on depth and branching factor D and B. Now next algorithm we are going to discuss is depth limited search algorithm. So we will cover this in next lecture. Thank you.